you know, people who are deconstructing from the church who are afraid of hell and still want to get to heaven aren't deconstructing. They aren't deconstructing. When you deconstruct, you have to tear it down. But if you're still trying to leave the cornerstone in place, all you're doing is refurbishing. You're renovating. You got to tear it all down. You know, when I tell people what it means to deconstruct, you have to be willing, fearlessly in some cases, or fearfully, fearfully brazen, fearfully bold, fearfully, you know, to the place where I don't give a damn if I'm going to fall, if I'm going to crash, if I'm going to just tear apart and just be obliterated by the universe, I'm going to give it a go. Most of us on the planet live our lives under 35 miles an hour. If we were to register our living in terms of speed, you know, from on the car from 0 to 120 miles per hour, most of us live between 35 and 40 miles an hour. Very few people are living so free, so weightless, with emotional tied downism. We live so weightless that we're capable of getting up into the big numbers. We're very cautious. We're codified. You know, we were taught what the book says. That's the explicit knowledge. This is the textbook. You study it. We're gonna test you on it. Now you know it. And many of us know how to take that knowledge and go out into the world, get a good job, because that's what's expected of us, following the code. Don't go past the stop sign without stopping. Don't do a rolling stop. You know, there's some sort of penalty for breaking the code. And we do that even in our own lives. I just so happen to be, you know, the motherfucker, I don't care. That's that big pedal down there, I'm going to mash it. I encourage people, as soon as you can, hit the gas and go, buddy, go. I mean, do something so foolishly out of your character that, you know, it brings you to the place where you have to look around and wonder where you are. What do you fear most about deconstruction? In other words, what do you fear most about being yourself? You know, what do you fear most about being yourself? Where does that lie? Is it you're afraid of having a conversation with your mom or your dad or your friends or your siblings about your new course of action, your new course of living, your new ideas about what's most important and what's not important at all anymore? I mean, what is your fear? Is it the fear of you losing the place of comfort that you have, the only place of comfort that makes you feel good about your connection to the world? It could be your job. It could be your place in the society. It could be your place amongst a peer group. Are you afraid of losing that? Are you afraid of having the conversation with your children after having taught your children the protocols, the codes, the ways that you're trying to escape from, and you see them following in that same pattern? Are you nervous about that? You know, so what is your fear? And I think that's a very serious question to consider, because that question alone is going to determine if your big foot, your big toe, is going to really mash down into the pedal of your life.